How to give an insulin injection. This video will explain the parts of the insulin syringe, how to draw up insulin, where to give insulin, and how to give an insulin injection. First, let's look at the parts of the insulin syringe. Insulin must be given with a special syringe. They come in different brands and sizes. Your diabetes team will tell you which size is right for your child. All syringes have the same basic parts. The orange cap protects the needle until we are ready to use the syringe. There is also a cap on the plunger side. The needle is the part that goes under the skin. The barrel measures the insulin dose. An insulin syringe will have lines showing insulin units. The plunger moves insulin in and out of the syringe. Next, let's look at the steps for drawing up insulin, or in other words, getting insulin from the vial into the syringe. You will need one vial of the correct insulin, one syringe, and one alcohol pad. Place the supplies on a clean, flat surface. Wash your hands with soap and water. You can also use hand sanitizer if you are not able to wash your hands. Make sure the name of the insulin on the vial is the medicine you want to give. Check your math and make sure the amount of insulin you will give is correct. Look at the insulin vial. If the medicine is past the expiration date, or if it is cloudy or has crystals, use another vial of the same insulin. Clean off the top of the insulin vial with alcohol. Let the alcohol dry before drawing up insulin. Carefully remove the plunger cap and the needle cap. Do not let the needle touch anything. Draw air into the syringe using the same number of units as the dose of insulin. For example, if your child's dose is 2 units, draw up 2 units of air. Now, push the syringe needle into the top of the insulin vial. Press the plunger to put the air into the vial. Turn the syringe upside down. Make sure the tip of the needle is in the insulin liquid. Pull back on the plunger to fill the syringe with the right amount of insulin. If there are large air bubbles in the syringe, push them back into the vial. Then, pull back on the plunger to fill the syringe with the right amount of insulin. You can repeat this until the large air bubbles are gone. When you are finished, make sure the syringe has the right amount of insulin and no large air bubbles. Where to give insulin injections? Insulin needs to be injected just under the skin. This is called a subcutaneous injection. Insulin will not work well if it is injected into muscle or scar tissue. Here are the places we can inject insulin. The outside of the arm, between the elbow and shoulder. The belly, below the rib cage, with the exception of the belly button area. The sides of the belly can also be used. The upper part of the buttocks and the upper hips. And the outside of the thighs. Next, let's see how to give an insulin injection. Here is what you need. One alcohol pad. One syringe filled with the right amount of the right insulin. And one container to throw out sharps. Step 1. Choose the place on the body where you will give the insulin. Step 2. Clean the skin with alcohol on that spot. Let it air dry. Do not blow on it to make it dry faster. Step 3. If your child is very thin, gently pinch up the top layer of skin with one hand. This is to make sure the insulin goes right below the skin and not into the muscle. Step 4. Hold the syringe at a 90-degree angle to the surface of the skin and push the needle through the skin. Make sure the entire needle is pushed through the skin. Step 5. If the skin is pinched, release the pinch. Push in the plunger of the syringe at a steady speed until the syringe is empty. Step 6. Wait 10 seconds before you remove the needle. Waiting 10 seconds keeps the insulin from leaking out. After 10 seconds, quickly remove the needle. Do not rub the area after you take out the needle. Step 7. Carefully throw out the syringe into the sharps container. Step 8. Write the time, insulin type, and amount of insulin you gave on the log sheet. You will be able to practice insulin injections with your diabetes team. They will work with you until you are comfortable injecting insulin on your own. If you have more questions about insulin, ask your diabetes team.